Hello and welcome to one more lesson in Science and Technology 2 called Introduction to Microbiology. And in this unit, we will learn how microbes are responsible for certain food products. Industrial microbiology is a branch of microbiology, and food production is one part of it. And in this unit, we will learn about the yogurt production, cheese and butter production, making of bread, and probiotics. Milk has a very low shelf life. That means it does not last for very long, and therefore it is converted into dairy products for preservation. The water content and acidity of milk changes when we change it from milk to, you know, either yogurt or cheese or some other dairy product. The texture, that is the feel, you know, your yogurt has a different feel, cheese has a different type of texture, so does butter. All these are dairy products. So the texture, taste and flavor is improved when we change it from milk to dairy product. The bacteria present in milk itself is used to make these products. Only cheese is produced with the help of fungi. Basic processes for the production of yogurt, cheese, cream is almost the same. Okay. So we have a process here called pasteurization. If we want to, you know, increase the shelf life or increase the expiry of milk products, then milk must be pasteurized. That it is heated to a high temperature, then cooled, so that all the microbes, unwanted microbes, are destroyed in milk. Okay. So milk is therefore, that process is called pasteurization, to destroy unwanted microbes. Then milk is fermented with the help of lactobacilli, the bacteria. The lactose, which is sugar in milk, now turns to lactic acid. Milk proteins come together and they coagulate, they come together due to this lactic acid. And compounds with taste and flavor are also formed. For example, diacetyl, which has the flavor of butter. So this is the basic process where milk is first pasteurized, then fermented, and then changed into, you know, yogurt, cheese, butter, etc. Yogurt is a milk product produced with the help of the bacteria called lactobacilli. For industrial production of yogurt, condensed milk powder is added to the milk to be fermented. Now at home, we just take milk, heat it, cool it, add a little yogurt which we have from before, and we get new curds or yogurt. But when they have to make it in very large quantities in industries, condensed milk powder is added to that milk which is supposed to be fermented. Now, when boiled milk is cool, they add bacterial strains of Streptococcus thermophilus and Lactobacillus delbrueckii in a one-to-one proportion. Equal proportion of these two bacteria are added to the cooled milk. Lactic acid is formed due to Streptococcus, and that lactic acid makes the proteins in the milk to gel, giving a little thicker or a dense consistency to yogurt. Some compounds like acetaldehyde are formed due to this lactobacilli, and they give a characteristic, you know, that little tangy little taste to yogurt. Various fruit juices can be added to impart different flavors, like we have strawberry, banana yogurt, sometimes we have vanilla yogurt, and so many other types of yogurt. Okay. Now, the shelf life or the expiry of yogurt and its probiotic properties can be improved by pasteurization. So, pasteurization being a very, very important process in the formation or the production of dairy products. So, this is what we do at home. We boil the milk, cool it, okay, and then we take yogurt which is already there. It may be from a packet or it may be what you already have at home, and your new vessel or the dish of yogurt is made. After yogurt, we come to the production of cheese. Now, cheese is produced on a very large scale from cow's milk. Initially, some chemical and microbiological tests are carried out on this milk. Then, some microbes like Lactobacillus lactis, Lactobacillus cremoris, Streptococcus thermophilus, along with some colors, are mixed with this milk. The milk becomes sour. Now, to get the dense or the thick texture of cheese, now, once you add this bacteria, the milk becomes sour. It becomes and forms into yogurt. Okay, but yogurt is a little, you know, more fluid than cheese. So we need to get that water which is there. It is called whey. When we make yogurt, slightly watery part remains in yogurt. That whey needs to be removed from yogurt to get the dense texture, that is the thick texture of cheese. Now, earlier there was an enzyme called rennet. It was taken from the alimentary canal of cattle and that was used to make cheese. Today, an enzyme protease, which is got from fungi, is used to produce vegetarian cheese. So, fungi is used to make cheese. The following steps take place after that: cutting of solid yogurt, washing it, rubbing it, salting it, mixing of essential microbes, okay, pigments and flavors. That is the flavor for taste, pigment for color. Cheese is then pressed and cut into pieces and then stored for some time for ripening. See, this is exactly how they make cheese on a large scale. First, in this huge trough itself, the milk comes here, and then those enzymes, the lactobacillus and bacteria strains are put into this. Okay, it forms a sort of a yogurt. That whey or the water from yogurt is drained out. Then they collect it. You know, they pat it down, rub it, salt it, press it down, cut it into pieces, and then it is stored for ripening. So, if you look at this, you will find the different types of processes that go into making cheese. Okay, see, the curds is formed or the yogurt formed, then they drain out the whey. Okay, then you see a coming down, salting, salt gets into it. Okay, then pouring into different molds. Okay, then keeping for ripening. Okay, so this is this lumps of cheese, not the ones that we get in the market, that is the processed cheese, the tins or the triangular shapes or the slices. This is the real cheese formed from enzymes and from bacteria. Next, we have the production of butter. Two types of butter are produced on a large scale. Those are sweet cream butter and cultured butter. Okay. Microbes are used for the production of the cultured variety. Sweet cream is a little softer kind of a butter. Next, we have the production of bread. Different types of bread are produced from flour of cereals. Flour meaning atta. Okay, so we take different cereals like wheat, rice, we grind them and then we can make bread out of them. A dough is formed by mixing baker's yeast, which is also called Saccharomyces cerevisiae. salt, water, and other materials. You know, you can add whatever else you want while making your bread. Now, what happens is this yeast ferments the carbohydrates, and sugar is converted into carbon dioxide and an alcohol called ethanol. The bread therefore becomes spongy because obviously carbon dioxide is produced, so that carbon dioxide is a gas, and when we bake the bread, that gas is trapped in these little holes that you have in bread, and bread becomes spongy. Now, yeast, very important in microbiology. Okay, dry granular yeast is used for domestic use. At home, when you want to make bread or any other food item, we use this kind of yeast in grains, small little grains. Compressed yeast is used in commercial bakery industry. Commercial means when we want to bake cakes and bread on a very large scale, to supply to different shops, etc., then this is the yeast that is used, compressed yeast. Yeast used in commercial bakery contains useful contents like carbohydrates, fats, proteins, vitamins, and minerals, and hence the product becomes very nutritive. So when we use this yeast, which is used in commercial bakery, not the domestic one, there are many nutrients mixed in that. So anything you make with this yeast becomes very nutritive. Products like vinegar, soya sauce, and monosodium glutamate, which is also called Ajinomoto, used in Chinese food, are produced by microbial fermentation. So you see, all these are used in Chinese food, and they are produced by microbes. So microbes are added in something, and the process called fermentation takes place, and these different products are formed. And now we come to a relatively new kind of food product called probiotics. Probiotics are milk products which contain active bacteria like Lactobacillus acidophilus, Lactobacillus casei, Bifidobacterium bifidum. All these active bacteria are put into these milk products. These microbes maintain the balance of intestinal microorganisms. They increase the population of useful microbes and decrease the harmful microbes like Clostridium. So why are these becoming important is because these maintain the balance of the microorganisms present in your intestine, the place where the food gets digested. Okay. Also, they increase the useful bacteria and they decrease the work of the harmful bacteria or microbes like Clostridium. There are a variety of available probiotic products. Some of them you can see here: yogurt, kefir, buttermilk, aged cheese, sauerkraut, that is cabbage pickle, miso, even chocolate, dark chocolate, sourdough, etc. Also, microalgae, that is sea, got from the sea, like spirulina, chlorella, blue-green algae, etc. See what this leaflet says. Want to look and feel your very best? Start enjoying more foods naturally high in probiotics and in the fiber-rich prebiotics that help those good bugs thrive. Good bugs meaning the microbes, the good microbes. Okay? Now, probiotics have become very important recently. Of late, more and more people want to go into the malls and, look for probiotic yogurt instead of the normal yogurt, or more and more probiotic foods. Now, these products are important because they form large colonies of useful microbes in our alimentary canal and also control other microbes and their activities. So, probiotic foods have active bacteria in them which help to improve our body's resistance to diseases and lower the bad effects of harmful substances in the body. Useful microbes become inactive due to antibiotics. Now, suppose you are sick and you go to the doctor and he prescribes specially broad spectrum antibiotics. You know, all the microbes in your body will be inactive or destroyed. And then if you have probiotic foods, they are with active bacteria. Once again, that process of, you know, making the bacteria begins and you have your alimentary canal back again with the useful microbes. Probiotics today are also used in the treatment of diarrhea. Diarrhea is that when you have loose motions and a lot of water, you know, goes out of your body as well. So at that time we take probiotic food, and also for the treatment of any sicknesses that poultry have. Pasteurization, given to us by the famous scientist Louis Pasteur, the process of heating milk and other beverage to a specific temperature to destroy the harmful microbes, that is known as pasteurization. Very, very important in the production of dairy and other foods.